I'm so excited about story time this morning. We're going to get started in just a second. Everybody find a seat. All right, are you ready? Well, let's get going. Welcome to Carver County Library Virtual Storytime. My name is Cindy, and I will be your storyteller for today. Now, when I do story time, we start with a song called the Storytime Song. Can you sing with me? Story time, welcome to our story time. With lots of books and fun for me and you, we will sing and dance too. All right, can you clap your hands? Clap your hands for story time, clap your hands for story time. With lots of books and fun for me and you, we will sing. Jump up high. Jump up high for story time. Jump up high for story time. With lots of books and fun for me and you, we will sing and dance too. Oh, very good. Let's do one more. How about spinning around? Spin around for story time. Spin around for story time. Lots of books and fun for me and you. We will sing and dance too. Very good. Thank you for singing with me. And now it is time to call out my friend Blossom. Can you call her with me? Say, Blossom. Say it really loud. Blossom. Oh, I think she heard you. Here she comes. Hello, 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 hello. Oh, look, her tail came out. Oh, that's great. Oh, Blossom, we got your tail this time. Yay! I always forget my tail, and you always have to remind me. I know, isn't that silly? Well, we are going to have a very fun story time today. Do we have a letter for today? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Uh-oh, let's see what it is. Oh, what is the letter? It's the letter S. S for silly. We said silly already. There's the letter S. And I have a lowercase letter S. You know the game we play with lowercase letters. Do you think it's the same or is it different than the uppercase letter S? What do you think? Is it the same or is it different? Let's look. Here's the lowercase letter S. There it is. You know, it looks a lot the same. Now, it's different because it's a different color, right? The uppercase is green and the lowercase is red, but they're the same shape, aren't they, Blossom? Yes, they are. Let's see. Can we put our finger up and we'll go around and around and around? That's the uppercase letter. And let's do the lowercase letter. Around, around, and up. That's it. Just, ooh, just like a snake. Oh, that's a good S word. Do you know what sound the letter S makes? S. Very good. It makes a sound s, kind of like a snake. Ooh. Oh, look, Blossom. I have the S bag. Let's see what's in there. There's things in here that begin with the letter S. Oh, Blossom found something. What's this? What's that? It's a seal. Seal begins with the letter S. What else is in the bag? Let's see. Oh, we said this. Look what we found. We found some snakes. Oh no. Hiss. Snake begins with the letter S. Oh, here's something else. What's that? It's a squirrel. Squirrel begins with the letter S. letter S. There's lots of things that begin with the letter S. And I betcha you could look around and find more things that begin with the letter S, right? Well, we have a word that begins with the letter S that sometimes comes up around this time of year. And it is scary. Oh, are you scared, Blossom? Oh, why are you scared? Because the word scary is scary. Oh, well, I suppose it could be. But this word scary, you can also be silly and scary at the same time. And that's kind of what we're going to do today. We're going to talk a little bit about being scared. And it's okay. And sometimes it's kind of fun. So let's say goodbye to Blossom. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, Blossom. She's going to go in her box. And we're going to have some stories about being scared. See, sometimes it's fun to be scared. Now, this first story has a little friend of mine here. Hello, this is Stevie. Can you say hi to Stevie? Hi, hi. Stevie, that begins with the letter S. Oh, it does, it begins with the letter S. My name, I'm an S, yay. Well, Stevie, this is Stevie's story about little Stevie and all the noises. Because sometimes noises can be scary too. Oh, is this a scary story? Oh, I get scared pretty easily. Well, let's see what happens to little Stevie. Now, this is a story that is written by a staff member here at the Carver County Library. I bet you could write a story too. Wouldn't that be fun? Maybe you could write a story today. And you could tell it. Well, this is little Stevie and all the noises. One night, little Stevie was trying to go to sleep. Now, I got a blanket here for little Stevie. Do you have a blanket on your bed? Oh, and do you cuddle up in it like this and get all snug and warm? Now, we're going to do a little fun rhyme every time Stevie tries to go to bed, because he tries to go to bed a couple times. And I want you to reach down and I want you to pull up the covers. Do that with me. Pull up the covers and then put your arms or put your hands around your arms and say, snuggle into bed, just like Stevie is. Snuggle into bed. And then we're going to turn out the light and then we're going to say good night. And you can put your hands together like this and go to sleep. Let's try that together. Ready? Pull up the covers, snuggle into bed, turn out the light, and say good night. Very good. So little Stevie was just trying to go to sleep. Oh, nice and warm. When all of a sudden he heard a noise. It went whoosh, roar, swoosh. And little Stevie leapt out of bed and he ran to find his mom and he said, Mama, 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 what was that noise? Can you say that with me? Mama, Mama, what's that noise? One more time. Mama, Mama, what's that noise? And his mama said, don't worry, Stevie. Don't worry. That's the noise. I want you to listen and I want you to guess what the noise is. Can you hear that? What is that noise? I bet you guessed it. Stevie's mommy said, that's just the noise an airplane makes. And it's just passing by. Oh, I like airplanes. Okay, so Stevie crawled back into bed. Are you ready? Let's pull up the covers, ready? Pull up the covers, snuggle into bed, turn out the light, and say good night. And Stevie's mom was making sure the blankets were just right around Stevie when there was another noise. Wee-oo, wee-oo, wee-oo. And Stevie bolted up and he said, ready? Mama, Mama, what's that noise? One more time. Mama, Mama, that noise? And his mama said, Stevie, it's okay, it's okay. That's the noise. Now here, we're gonna listen. What noise is that? Have you heard that noise before? Right. That's the noise a police car makes. And it's just passing by. Oh, I like the police. They're really nice. Yeah, they are. They're very nice, aren't they? All right. So let's get back in bed. Ready? Pull up the covers. Snuggle into bed. Turn out the light and say good night. Oh, Stevie's mom was giving him a kiss goodnight on the cheek. And Stevie was just starting to feel sleepy when he heard another noise. Rumble thunk, rumble thunk. Ooh. And Stevie scurried from his room. Mama, mama, what's that noise? And his mama said, don't worry, sweetie. Let's hear what that noise was. What do you think Stevie heard? Right! Stevie heard a train. That's the noise a train makes. Oh, and it's just passing by. Oh, I like trains. Trains are really fun. Stevie climbed up on the couch next to his mama and snuggled in. And mama was giving him a big hug when all of a sudden she heard a noise. Gurgle. Stevie, what was that noise? And Stevie went, oh, that's the noise my tummy makes. Stevie's mom said, oh, sweetie, I have just the thing for that. And she took Stevie into the kitchen for his favorite snack. Do you have a favorite snack? That's the story of little Stevie and all the night noises. Yeah, that was fun. And we are going to make a snack. So I want you to make a big pot in front of you with your hands. You can stand up and do this, okay? And we're gonna make a big pot. Now, I don't know how you make popcorn, but in my house, we still make it in a pot on the stove. And sometimes people make it in a pot over a fire. So that's what we're pretending. We're gonna have a big pot and we're gonna put in some oil. So you have to pour in some oil and you have to put in some popcorn. And then when you have a pot on the stove and not a popcorn popper, you have to shake your pot. So we're gonna shake it and we're gonna say sizzle while we shake it. And then what happens at the end, do you know? What happens with popcorn once it's cooking? It goes pop, and you can jump up high and pop. All right, let's start. Put your pot out in front of you. We're put the oil in the pot and we let it get hot. We put the popcorn in and we start to grin, smile, because we like popcorn. Now let's cook it. Sizzle, 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 pop! Oh, very good. One more time. Let's make some more popcorn so we have enough for our caregivers and our brothers and sisters. Ready? You put the oil in the pot and you let it get hot. You put the popcorn in, you start to grin. Sizzle, 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 pop! Oh, very good. All right, now take some of that imaginary popcorn and sit down and put it in a bowl. And you, because it's imaginary popcorn, you can put anything you want on it. You could put imaginary chocolate on it. You could put imaginary sprinkles on it. I like salt and I like cheese on my popcorn. Mm-hmm. So go ahead and put whatever you want on your imaginary popcorn, and you can sit and eat your imaginary popcorn while I tell you the next story. Now, the next story is a scary story that you can tell your family. It's an old, you might call it a ghost story, but there's no ghosts in this one. There's no ghosts in this one. So we'll just say it's a scary story, an old folk tale called In the Dark, Dark Woods. Now, when you tell a scary story, the way you use your voice makes a difference. Did you know that? So if I told you a story and I said, in the dark, dark wood, there was a dark, dark, that doesn't sound very scary, does it? But if I say, in the dark, dark wood, then it becomes scarier. So when you tell this story, you need to practice saying it with a scary voice, if you want to say scary. But Stevie is going to help me, and we're going to put some pictures up here as we tell the story. So it starts out, little Stevie, in a dark, dark wood. So let's put up a picture of a dark, dark wood. What do you think a dark, dark woods looks like? Let's see what Stevie has. Let's see what Stevie has. Well, Stevie, that doesn't look like a dark, dark wood. That looks like a bright, sunny wood, and look, there's even butterflies in it. Stevie, that's not scary. I don't like scary. I like it bright and sunny. I want to stay in a bright and sunny woods. Well, you could say that in your story, but I'm trying to teach the kids how to say a spooky story. So let's start with a dark, dark woods. So let's do my picture. Oh, this one's scary. Look at that. Oh, that's a dark wood. All right, so we say, in a dark, dark woods, there was a dark, dark path. Now, what's a path? A path is a place to walk through the trees, right? Do you have a picture of a dark, dark path, Stevie? Wait a second. That's not a dark and scary path. Oh, nope. It's a nice, clean, pretty, shiny. It's a nice, lighted path. I like that because you can see the whole way down. I like it. It's not spooky. Oh, Stevie, you're so funny. We're going to try a dark, dark path. Here's a dark, dark path. Let's put this one up because that one's dark. Ooh, look. There's a dark, dark path. So the story goes so far. In a dark, dark wood, there was a dark, dark path. And on that dark, dark path, there was a dark, dark house. Do you have a house? Oh, yes. Stevie has a house. Let's see if it's dark. Is that a dark house? No. Silly Stevie. That's a bright and sunny and pretty colored house. That's silly Stevie. Let's do a dark house. Ooh, I got a dark and scary house. Look at that one. Oh, that one looks dark and scary. Oh, so now we have in a dark, dark woods, there's a dark, dark path. And in the dark, dark path, there's a dark, dark house. And in the dark, dark house, there's a dark, dark room. Do you have a room? Oh, Stevie has a room. There we go. Well, that doesn't look like a scary dark room. Look, there's a fire and a lamp and some cushy chairs. That's not dark and scary. Ooh, here's a dark, dark room. That one doesn't look very fun to go into, so we'll put the dark, dark room up there. What's in the dark, dark room, Stevie? Can you say it? In the dark, dark room, there was a dark, dark cupboard. Ooh, a dark, dark cupboard. Do you have a cupboard, Stevie? I do. There's a cupboard. Is that a dark, dark cupboard? No. That is a white, shiny cupboard with pretty glass pieces in it. That's not very dark. Let's look at this. How about this one? Ooh, that's a dark, dark cupboard. It looks like there could be spiders in there, right? Ooh, so there's the dark, dark cupboard. And what's in the dark, dark cupboard, Stevie? Oh, I know this story. In a dark, dark cupboard, there was a dark, dark shelf. A dark, dark shelf? Do you have a picture of a dark, dark shelf? Not really. Well, let's see what you have. Oh, what does Stevie have? Stevie has a shelf full of ducks. That's not dark and scary, is it? That's silly, Stevie. That would be a fun story, though, to have silly ducks. But I have a dark and scary shelf. It's got books on it, which are nice, but it's dark. And then what's next? In a dark, dark shelf, there was a dark, dark box. A dark, dark box. Do you have a dark, dark box? No. Stevie, look at Stevie's box. Stevie's box is not dark. It's pretty, and it's covered with shells. It's a pretty box. It is a pretty box. I want to open this box. It looks like it would have fun things in it. You want to see my box? No. Uh-oh. Look, I have a dark, dark box. I wonder what's in there. So, at the end, we find out what's in the box. So tell the story with me, okay? Let's start up here. In a dark, dark wood. Remember, say it with a scary voice. In a dark, dark woods, there was a dark, dark path. And on the dark, dark path, there was a dark, dark house. And on the dark, dark house, there was a dark, dark room. Oh, let me do it. And in the dark, dark room, there was a dark, dark cupboard. And in the dark, dark cupboard, there was a dark, dark shelf. And in the dark, dark shelf, there was a dark, dark box. See, you can be scary because you can get quieter too. But what's in the box? This is the part of the story where you get to decide what's in the box. When I get to the dark, dark box, I normally say, in the dark, dark box, there was a purple jelly bean! And then we all laugh. And that's funny. You could put anything you want. Maybe you want a hot dog in your box. Or maybe, I know. In the dark, dark box, there was a little orange cat. Yes, there could be a little orange cat in your box. And that's how the story goes. And you can make it any way you want. And if you want to have a silly, funny shelf in your story with ducks on it, you could do that. Because that's a fun story. That's fun. And that is our scary, scary story for today. So say goodbye to Stevie. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, Stevie. Thank you. And now it is almost time to end, but we're going to do a quick song because I want to do a quick song, and then we'll call out Blossom. Another thing that's scary are dinosaurs. So I want you to stand up, and I want you to pretend to be a dinosaur. Dinosaurs roar, roar. Ready? Roar. There's lots of things to do in this song. Dinosaurs roar, roar. Dinosaurs roar. Dinosaurs march around. Dinosaurs roar, roar. Dinosaurs roar, roar. Dinosaurs up and down. Now I need you to dance like a dinosaur. How do you think a dinosaur dances? Dinosaur dance. Dinosaurs prance, dinosaurs twirl around. Dinosaurs dance, dinosaurs prance, dinosaurs touch the ground. Now roar again. Dinosaurs roar, roar. Dinosaurs roar, roar. Dinosaurs stomp the ground. Dinosaurs roar, roar. Dinosaurs roar, roar. Dinosaurs up and down. Now I need you to march like a dinosaur. March around the room. Dinosaurs march, dinosaurs march, dinosaurs march around. Dinosaurs march, dinosaurs march, dinosaurs touch the ground. Now, roar again. Dinosaurs roar, roar, dinosaurs roar, roar, dinosaurs stomp around. Dinosaurs roar, roar, dinosaurs roar, roar, dinosaurs up and down. Oh, time to go to sleep, dinosaurs, just like Stevie tried to do. Dinosaurs sleep, dinosaurs peep, dinosaurs quiet now. Dinosaurs peep, dinosaurs sleep, dinosaurs on the ground. Dinosaurs roar, roar, dinosaurs roar, roar, dinosaurs stomp around. Dinosaurs roar, roar, dinosaurs roar, roar, dinosaurs up and down. Very good. All right, it is time to call out Blossom. Let's call out Blossom. Say, Blossom! Blossom, can you hear them? Here she comes. Here she comes. Hello, hello, hello! Oh, she forgot her tail. Can you tell her? Oh, your tail, Blossom. Thank you for telling her, because she always forgets it. I am so glad you came today. Now, you know, next week is a super story time again. Yay! So, the week before Halloween, we're going to have a take and make craft that you can pick up at your library. And it goes with one of the story times of the week. I think it's Monday night. And you have, but you can check our website and find out what time the super story time is. And don't forget to come pick up your kit next week. And you have a great day. All right, say goodbye, Blossom. Bye-bye. Oh, wait, we got to play Jack in the Box. Everyone, get into your boxes. Get into your boxes. Be really quiet. Jack in the Box, so quiet and still. Will you come out? Yes, I will. All right, we'll see you later. Bye-bye.